Hey, Jim here from K2 Concepts, shooting another in our series of dipping difficult parts. We're going to dip the rear fender on a razor, and I'm going to show you guys what to look for, and hopefully some of this information will translate into when you guys are looking at other parts, because obviously not all parts are the same, but the principles we're going to teach you. So, couple of them, looking at the part, realizing where you're going to have problems in the dip when the pattern rolls up on it. The second is your technique, okay? I see a lot of voids and underactivating and stuff like that. A lot of it is related not so much to the part, but more towards your technique. And that's something that I've always emphasized and I think you guys need to work on. So follow me through this. The first step is why we're going to dip this the way we do. The second step is you're going to watch as my technique when we go through the water, maintain the angle. Okay, alright, so going to get the pattern in the water. This is Brent's carbon fiber 501. Really nice pattern, like it. It's thirsty. For a single ink pattern, it's pretty darn thirsty. So I'm using some training wheels since this pattern, this part is pretty darn big. So there you go. No air. Okay, we're gonna set our timer. Alright. Get our gloves on. Today we're having a little scotty for the haters. Not too many more left. It's kind of funny, but it's okay. All right, a little Takati light. All right, now the reason that we're gonna dip this a certain way, first of all, you can see we back tape all the edges because you're gonna have falling edges. Secondly, the holes, make sure no water comes in from the backside to splash it up in the pattern. Now, getting back to how we're going to dip it, you could probably dip it this way, coming in from this side, but the problem is, especially right in here, what's going to happen is the pattern's going to gather or pinch up, okay, and you're going to have a weird looking setup, void, whatever, versus coming in this way and coming up and flowing around the pattern. As long as you maintain a good angle, you should get the air out of there, even if you trap it. It's still going to look better than the pattern gathers. So what I'm saying is, the pattern's going to gather on a point, or it's going to disperse. So that's the way, that's why we're dipping it this way, coming in this way. All right, so timer's gone off, we're ready to go. Using Hydrovator, we're going to soak it. Go ahead, hit it. All right, hands on. Something that bolts on there, but everywhere else, nice dip. All right, so we'll get that in the rinse tank. So again, as you approach your parts and as you're planning on your dip, you just can't take parts and just slam them. It doesn't work like that. You really got to think about what the pattern's going to do when it flows on the parts. And sometimes you're not going to know just through, or you're not going to learn until you have experience. So you're going to have some voids, you're going to create problems for yourselves or have to redo parts or whatever it is. Some of those things are only due can only be learned by experience. But at the end of the day, we're hoping that this series of videos that we've done on difficult parts really helps you guys plan your approach, not just take something and stick it in the water and wonder why it did what it did, all right? So anyhow, join us on the forum, k2forums.com. You can email me, k2forums@gmail.com. If you need activator guns and other supplies, k2shoponline.com. And that's it for this one. I hope you guys have a good day dipping. We'll talk to you later.